It's March Madness in college hoops. Also March Madness when it comes to overthrowing dictators, apparently. So we're coming out with the dictator brackets. We're going to find out which dictators are more likely to keep their grip on power and survive to the end. So let's go to the seedings. We start with a one seed in former President Egypt, Hosni Mubarak, who's been a one seed for decades. Mubarak takes on surprising four seed Muammar Gaddafi. Gaddafi was on the bubble, but he's been on the bubble for 40 years. The next matchup features two seed Mahmoud Ahmadinejad of Iran facing three seed former dictator of Tunisia Zine al-Abidine Ben Ali. And over in the next bracket, we have the perennial favorite King Abdullah of Saudi Arabia taking on four seed Yemen's president Ali Abdullah Saleh. And in the final matchup, Bashar al-Assad of Syria goes up against the King Hamad of Bahrain. So here we go. How's it going to work out? The matchups are set. Let's take a look at what happens in the brackets. In the first matchup, Gaddafi upsets Hosni Mubarak. Who saw that coming? Down goes Mubarak. He went home before Gaddafi. Mubarak was once a powerhouse, but how the mighty have fallen. This upset win might finally earn Colonel Gaddafi a promotion. Will this guy ever become a general? In the next matchup, Ahmadinejad takes it. This was a laugher. Ahmadinejad was pressed early in 2009. He unfortunately hung in there, and Ben Ali was bounced out of the tournament first. Then in the Middle East bracket, well, they're all the Middle East bracket, actually, we are projecting King Abdullah over Saleh. Saleh's top general turned on him earlier in the week, so he might be going home sooner than expected. And we are projecting al-Assad to outlast King Hamad, who's been shaky in Bahrain. So we are down to the final four: Gaddafi, Ahmadinejad, Abdullah, and al-Assad. This Gaddafi-Ahmadinejad matchup has got Vegas going wild. It's a tough call. Both are vicious fighters who have a knack for hanging around. But Gaddafi already has F-15s overhead, so we're projecting Ahmadinejad to go all the way to the finals. And in the other final, the al-Assad family has been running Syria for decades, but Bashar is no Hafez. Syria doesn't have oil, Abdullah in a walk here. So we believe the finals will be Ahmadinejad from Iran versus King Abdullah of Saudi Arabia. This could go to final death. And by the way, that is really the Middle East, Iran versus Saudi Arabia. And in the end, we are projecting the winner of the dictator brackets as King Abdullah. He's got all the oil, and he's got us on his side, so he's likely to win.